Oof. All right. Thank you. So welcome to Amsterdam, and welcome to Ross Video's very first European keynote. Very excited to be here for our first IBC keynote. And our agenda, three basic points. We're going to be talking about Ross Smart Production and what that means. We're going to be talking, of course, about some new products. And of course, we have quite a few surprises for you tonight. So very excited about that. And first, a brief corporate update. Let's have the graph. So we have averaged 17% growth every single year since 1991. We are now heading into our 25th year of non-stop, not a single down year growth. And we've done that without any external private equity investment or anything like that. We did it through our customers buying our products. And I don't think there's any company at this point in the history of our industry that can actually say that. So that's fantastic. And we only have 2 months left in our financial year, and we're up 20% over last year. So we're trending up faster than historical growth, even though we're getting bigger. So what can I say? Thank you for your support. Now, there is another way to measure how you're doing in the industry. And I think the definitive company that does these things is the Devoncroft Big Broadcast Survey. And it measures market sentiment. In fact, when you order this fantastically expensive document that comes with 1,700 pages, there is one page that is the first one you want to go to. And that's overall brand strength, looking at all things considered globally. Now, that's measuring it across like the nearly 2,000 companies in our industry, and they look at, say, the top 100 of those for the detailed information. And how did we do last year? Very interesting. Let's take a look. We are 25th in overall brand strength of all companies in the entire industry. And remember, we're competing against companies that have consumer divisions like Canon, like Apple, like Sony. 25th isn't too bad. 1 year later, where do we sit? 18th. We moved up 7 spots in 1 year. That is a fantastic thing. In fact, the company that we're neck and neck with, side by side, globally, is now Grass Valley, one of the largest broadcast-specific companies in our industry. One of the things I really want to see is how that stands next year. It's going to be very, very interesting. And remember, this is a global number. What do customers think of us? When they think of Ross, apparently they think of value, quality, and ease of use. And we're going to be talking about things like that throughout this presentation. We're not stopping that at all. So we're growing globally as well. By the way, this is using our Ross Expression Map software. That's our local Iroquois office, an Ottawa office. And you can see we have quite a few offices across all of North America. A lot of growth there as well. 2 years ago, we opened Pinewood Studios inside the gates for more sales support, demonstration facilities, that sort of thing. This year, actually, as we're speaking, we're doubling the size of our Singapore office, moving to new space. Looking forward to the formal opening of that. So major investment into Asia. And of course, Australia, we're pleased to announce that we are now opening our facility in Sydney as well. So a lot of global expansion going on there, especially for demo, training, sales, and support to help all of our customers around the world. So let's talk about more local, IBC. What's our show going to be about? It's obviously a big show for us, and we're going to be talking about smart production. That's our theme, and explains a little bit about how we think at Ross. Let's take a look at smart production. We understand that we're in a creative industry and our customers need us to be creative. We have to understand the business that they're in as well and think about the dollars and cents and how we can help people be more cost effective in what they do. And Ross Video is a technology company, so at the hub of all that is the investment that we make into technology to make all of that happen, make all of that possible. So one of the things we want to start talking about in the technology right off the top is let's talk about IP. Now, you would think from all of the hype in our industry, and there's a few people sitting in this audience that may be also responsible for that hype, like the media, that you're just echoing what we say as manufacturers. You'd think that IP was mainstream, that you could just buy everything off the street almost, but it's got to be honest, it's still very early days. It's very hard to put down, especially a live production solution from multiple vendors and actually have it work and know that it's going to be the standard that's going to stick around for quite a few years. Having said that, I want to get you excited about where Ross is headed with IP, because I'm very excited about what we're doing. Now, we're already an Aspen member, and now Ross has joined Ames as well. So we're a full voting member, and we're very active now with all the open standards and committees that Ames is promoting. So you don't have to worry about Ross and IP. In fact, we're going to be showing on our booth a technology demonstration, perhaps a very advanced technology demonstration. In other words, we're very excited about how well it's working, called Raptor. Now, Raptor is this card, and it's being used in this case as a top-of-rack gateway. It's an open gear card. It's using the latest onboard processing. Note, two fans, not just one. It's got 12 gig SDIIO and 10 gig fiber, and lots of it on this one card. And as a unique feature, it's configurable as either 12 gig or IPIO. That's very useful with where we're headed. Now, what are we going to make with that? Let's take a look. We're working on a Raptor-based IP router. That's exciting. Based on COTS IP infrastructure, like Cisco. And it's going to be using NMOS discovery, using LSB, BFA compatible control layers, and going in and out of a Cisco switch or all the other types of switches we're talking about, it's going to be these Raptor cards. This is very important, very exciting. So you have SDIIP going in and out. Each one of these cards can do six channels of encapsulation de-encapsulation. So whether you want SDI coming in or IP going out, it can handle it both ways, and you can just load up your OpenGear frames and build your router out of some modular products that is infinitely expandable based upon COTS infrastructure. We're going to be showing that sort of technology coming on our booth. Very exciting. And maybe not entirely out of nowhere, because we had some interesting challenges with this technology. It's not easy. You have to know broadcast and networking and a whole lot of cutting-edge technology that's just emerging today. So we worked with a company named COVELOZ. They were live networking experts, and they really helped us build this IP gateway. If it turns out, they have a whole suite of media IP technology, and they were a consulting company. They weren't a product company, they were a consulting company, and they really did a lot of good work partnering with other companies such as Intel, which recently bought Altera, which makes a lot of the chips that makes everything go in our industry. Very, very smart guys. In fact, we liked the company and the people so much, we decided to make them part of the Ross family of companies. So I'm pleased to announce that we have just made acquisition number 11 for Ross Video. They just didn't work for us, though. They were making product for a number of companies that shall not be named in our industry, bringing IP technology forward because it is a very hard, specialized technology. Now that they're part of Ross, we're going to make sure that they can continue to do that as an arm's length subsidiary of Ross. And to be able to talk about this and how they're going to bring IP to the industry, I'd like to welcome the president of COVELOZ, Nestor Amaya. Nestor, come on up. And congratulations.
Good evening, everyone. I am thrilled to have the strength of Ross behind us. Now, I'm guessing many of you here are not familiar with COVELOZ. We make stuff that no one typically sees, the stuff that goes inside the box. We make core media technology. We program chips that equipment vendors need in order to move their gear towards IP. Our technology makes it easy for everyone to move to IP. So here's a little backstory. About 7 years ago, I founded COVELOZ to serve system-on-chip designs to the networking giants. You all know the companies. We did everything from 500 gigabit per second optical networking chips to low latency packet processors. For as long as I've been an engineer, we've been at the cutting edge of networking systems. And while serving these tier one customers, I saw an opportunity in the broadcast industry's transition to IP. A transition that's very much like what telecom did when they moved from circuits to packets. I thought, hey, I've seen this movie before. So ever since then, we've been focused on developing core media technology, what I like to call time-sensitive networking technology, packaged in easy-to-use apps, placing COVELOZ at the intersection of networking and broadcast pro AV industries. We're at the forefront of IP standards, deeply involved in all of the associations that you see here behind me. We're embedding these standards as they evolve into our chips. We're here to drive economies of scale, to accelerate the adoption of the AIMS roadmap by all players in the media industry. We enable your suppliers to focus on their strengths. Ever since the launch of our AES67 module, which came complete with Ravenna discovery and control, and now with our TRO3 and TRO4 system on chips, which include the NMOS discovery and registration software, our mission is to drive the adoption of time-sensitive networking technologies by supplying the foundation, the core foundational technology that should be common to all. This stuff should not be differentiating. So we make OEM hardware, for example, boards and modules. We design virtual chips. We offer our clients engineering consultancy and software to help them develop differentiated systems quickly and efficiently. And key to our mission is our partnership with Altera, now part of Intel. Intel's chips serve as our canvas. Our designs are powered by Intel chips. Together, we paint a future that will keep pace with your system needs as they evolve. From today's dedicated hardware to a dynamic and virtualized tomorrow, Intel's virtualization roadmap is really exciting stuff. Now, Ross has committed to support us as an independent company. I stay on as president, we keep our offices, and that's so that we can continue to offer our live networking expertise to everyone, including Ross competitors, and of course, Open Gear partners. I welcome you to see our technology in action at the Intel stand, at the IBC IP interoperability zone, the Arista Networks booth, a number of our clients as well, and of course, at Ross's booth. I really hope to see you on the show floor. And now back to Dave.
Thank you. So, if there is ever any doubt that Ross Video wasn't landing an IP with both feet, I hope the fact that we have this engineering powerhouse of networking and broadcast and AV experts with over 35, I think, engineers dedicated to nothing but moving forward video over IP for the entire industry. I'm very, very excited about that. So Ross and COVELOZ moving the industry forward. Now, in addition to Raptor, we also are showing an IP education zone. We showed this at NAB. We've updated it for IBC. It was very, very popular at NAB. We had quite a few customers saying, you guys made it so clear, and it was so unbiased as to what was really going on, and you could explain it so well, this was worth my entire trip to Vegas. So if you have any questions and concerns or confusion about what's going on in IP, I really recommend you go to the IP education zone. Your time will be well spent, and we can even give you an IP playbook, either in PDF format, or maybe we have a few copies as well. It's worth taking it as a giveaway. Now, that's a bit of what Ross is doing in IP, just a little bit, bought a company that's helping the entire industry already. Notice that we're also making virtual chips. So Ross is now in the chip business. Kind of cool, really, with Intel as our big brother partner. I love that. So, but the world is not just IP. For Ross, it's IP and SDI. Because SDI is still going strong. That's what most people are still buying today, and for a lot of good reasons. And we believe going forward, SDI has a future as well. And a big part of that future is 12 gig. 12 gig, single stream, 4K. Ross is already a leader in 12 gig SDI, and our jump into IP does not mean we're gonna jump out of 12 gig SDI. We're gonna solve both problems. And one of our flagship 12 gig products is our Ultrix router. It's fantastic. It's so small. You'd think it couldn't possibly do much in one RU. But we launched it at last IBC, and it captured the imagination of the industry and the competition, by the way. We heard that. And it won awards as well. And it's probably because it's more than just a 12 gig router. It does audio processing like there's no tomorrow, and it's a multi-viewer powerhouse. It's unbelievably compact. At one or two RU, it has 12 gig on every single IO, up to 72 squared. The audio matrix is 1,536 squared with embedders and disembedders on everything, plus at the same time has 12 Ultrascape multi-viewers. So let me show you. We decided, like, people, you want to understand this. You want to, like, how significant is this compared to the industry as it is today? So some of our engineers decided to devote, like, a day or two of their time to build a system that matches Ultrix. This is a routing, SDI, embedding, disembedding infrastructure. Took a long time. Now let's take a look. Let's compare this to Ultrix. That's it? That's all? Holy cow. Okay, let's take a good, thank you. Now let's go further. Let's say we want to do the same thing, but now we don't just care about audio embedding and disembedding. We want to do routing, and if it's not 12G and it's 3G, you need a big ass router up here. You need all of your IO conversion and everything else, and you need multiviewers. These are some of the most compact industry standard multiviewers out there, and it still takes up all that space, plus all your network switches and stuff like that, and power management on the top. That is state of the art before Ultrix, state of the art. People are selling these by the gazillion. It's not very integrated. Let's compare Ultrix. This is the same thing. This is the power of that little box that you might not have noticed going through our trade show, you know, at IBC last year or NAB. That's the Ultrix difference. And let's take a look here. The difference in size is 54 RU to 2, although I think you can see that. The weight difference is 600 pounds compared to 24. What difference does that make in an OB van? Oh my God. The power is 9 kilowatts versus 300 watts. And the number of cables, which is probably one of the biggest issues, let alone cost, is 4,000 cables on the left Anybody want to wire 4,000 cables or pay somebody to do that? And the weight of that versus 150 on the right. Pay attention to Ultrix, and we're still moving forward. This is a product that is not going to stop, and we're going to be showing even more new things on the show floor with Ultrix. So, it's so good. Customers are very excited, and these were used for the Olympics and the Australian Open Tennis, just to name a few cool names. Now, that is an example of a smart production solution. It gets even better on our stand. We're showing complete end-to-end production workflows, not just products, but whole workflows where customers can find what they do on our booth. I think that should be extremely valuable to clients. It's more than just having a coffee stand to socialize what we're showing on the booth. But don't worry, we do have coffee. We have coffee too. So, what are you showing up here? We're showing automated production workflows. We're showing legislative production. We're showing news editorial. I'm not talking about products, am I? I'm talking about whole solutions. I'm talking about graphics workflow. What else are we talking about? Stadium production. This stadium down here, like, it's a huge screen that really mimics a real stadium experience. We're showing the IP system in education, like I mentioned earlier. We're showing an integrated virtual studio. Let's take a moment to take a look at that a little bit more closely. So, this is a total solution for virtual sets and augmented reality. Total solution. No company in the world has anything even close to the breadth of product to be able to solve this problem than Ross today. We have, of course, our acid cameras, which is our new green screen and other screens, but green screen 444 high-resolution chroma cameras that we developed specifically to solve green screen problems that were being ignored by everybody else in the camera business. We also launched a set of high-end chroma keyers to be able to accept this high bandwidth input. Of course, we have our Furio and Cambot tracking systems, camera motion systems. If you want to have a virtual set, you want to have camera motion because that's what really sets this off. We're showing Carbonite production switcher working, our UX tracking integration that ties together the real and the virtual and everything inside of it. A touchscreen that the talent can use to run an entire production in the palm of their hands on their own. We're showing expression rendering, of course, and graphics, which is the power behind this. And we're also going to, of course, talk about the large number of deployments that we have, because we actually think not only do we have the broadest line, we are now developing the broadest customer base in the world for virtual sets and augmented reality. We're serious about this, and as you can tell, we've been building up a portfolio of cameras and graphics and so forth to be able to do this really well. But now, I have a special surprise. I want to talk about a company called The Future Group. The Future Group is a company that Ross doesn't own, but we are an investor in. Yeah, that's a whole other series. You sometimes ask me how many companies we've invested in that you don't know about. But this is a Ross investment. And Ross is also, in return, the Future Group's technology partner. So we bring some of their technology to market, and we help them as well with our technology, with our robots and chroma keyers and cameras, help them do what they do. So to talk about what we are doing together, I'd like to introduce the Chief Experience Officer of the Future Group, Ken Oling. Ken, come on up.
Thank you very much, David. Hi, everybody. Welcome to IBC. We're very excited to be here, and we're very excited about our collaboration with Ross. So a little bit later, I'm going to go into some more details. But right now, I want to talk a little bit about the Future Group. The Future Group is a three-year-old company based in Oslo, Norway. And our goal has been to merge multiple media types and develop new forms of entertainment. By way of that, we've been developing technology related to video game engines and software. With that in mind, I have a video here that I'm going to show you with someone who knows a little bit about video game technology to tell you about some of what we're doing.
I think that the Future Group, when people ask me why, I say I've always been fascinated with, first of all, the future, the time has come where media of all types and gaming needs to have the kind of fusion that this technology brings. What I love about very flexible platforms is that we don't know what they're going to be in 5 years. I think that this company can be a standard construct for new kinds of entertainment.
So that is coming from the founder of Atari. Some people consider him to be the father of video games. So from there, I am very, very happy to announce Frontier by the Future Group, our flagship collaboration with Ross in the development of a virtual studio component capable of creating unprecedented graphics. In this virtual set environment, virtual sets are very difficult. To create believable, realistic virtual sets takes a lot of energy and a lot of effort. With Frontier, we're able to do extremely high levels of graphics, high levels of effects, unbelievable quality, at faster, easier, and more flexible a system. The way we're able to do this is we're using video game engines. So for the past 3 years, we've been in a collaboration with Epic Games' Unreal Engine, and we've been developing on top of that to make the engine applicable in the broadcast industry. What that means to you guys is more realistic, more capable, more flexible, more spectacular types of graphics in your virtual set and controlled by your virtual studio. One of the ways that we do that is we take advantage of physical-based effects. And what physical-based effects are things like shadows, for example. Shadows that are more believable, shadows that will interact with lighting and lighting effects. Things that, like lighting effects, like, for example, lens flares. Lens flares that would make J.J. Abrams happy. We have dynamic textures. Dynamic textures are kind of a next generation of texture where you can do things like you can put rain on a window and it looks like it's actually raining. Or you could take an object and set it on fire. And once it burns up, it turns into charcoal. Or a piece of ice on a table that melts as someone is standing in the virtual set. You can also use it for more subtle things. So you can take things like dust particles in the air. And so your camera is going across and it sees the dust particles. So you're able to create this very immersive, very beautiful environment using this video game engine. Video game engines for the past 10 years have been evolving. And today, they rival that of Hollywood film effects. So we can take that now. We can give it to you guys. And you can turn it into amazing, spectacular things. But it's a video game engine, right? What do video game engines do? They do interactivity and they do animation. So we take that and we give that to you as well. But we do better than that. We expose it into Ross's UX. We make it so you guys can interact with elements. You can trigger animations. You can have interactive objects interact within the space. And you can control it all from inside of UX in real time, yeah? Real time, not post, in real time, okay? This is amazing, and we call this interactive mixed reality. With that, I want to show you some of these amazing graphics and show you how it integrates into the real-time TV pipeline. So pay attention here to the bloom. Pay attention to the shadows and the reflections. How you can focus all the way through the set. See the rain on that window? You can make that. You can change the weather by a push of a button. You have exposure to all of the components within your virtual set. You can move things around. You can adjust them. You can trigger animations. You can cause things to react in the environment. You can build simulations. All of this has tight integration. This is Frontier by the Future Group, our flagship collab. Thank you. We've been working very hard with Ross, and we're very much looking forward to seeing you guys at the booth, showing you more, fielding your questions, and developing the next generation virtual studio. Thank you very much.
Thanks. So I am really, really excited about being able to bring photorealistic imagery and physics to the virtual set. And that's what Ross is going to be showing a technology demonstration of on our booth at IBC this year. Very excited. Now, let's talk about sports stadiums, because we do a lot of different things, not just virtual sets. Behind me is a list of just some of the Euro customers that have signed up to Ross. Not a surprise, because Ross is the undisputed number one global leader in sports stadium production. In fact, if you go to our office, you'll see a wall of hats of every single sports team that some of you may have seen it as well. It fills a huge wall of all the current sports teams that use Ross. It's quite impressive. We have fun with it. So, at IBC, we're going to be showing a complete stadium experience with expression, acuity switchers, Carbonite switchers, Ultrix routers, open gear technology, and the new exciting product that we're also launching at NAB and showing now is Expression Tessera. That gives our customers everything that's needed for a superior fan engagement. Well, everything that these guys want, except for one thing, actually. In sports stadiums, it's almost really like one thing we don't make in the control room. Replay. Tonight, we're solving that problem as well. I'm pleased to announce another acquisition. It's two for one show. Abekas. Abekas is obviously an iconic industry brand. I have the respect for the history of Abekas and the current products. It actually means something to me personally. I called up my dad, actually, still with us. He's turning 81 in a couple of days. And he is like, "You're buying Abekas? That's cool." So anyway, this is what we like to say. It's our latest acquisition, because all of a sudden, poor Nestor over there, he's now old news. That was like an hour and a half ago. So let's talk a little bit about Abekas. It's a great fit. What do they have? Well, they have video server technology that I think we really could take a lot of great use out of their technology. And of course, replay systems. Have a quick look at their products. Okay, so this is Air Cleaner. It's a profanity elimination delay product. It's actually kind of a cool thing. Red button for video, red for audio, yellow for video. So that guy doesn't end up on the air. This is audio and video cover up. Next one, Mirror Replay. Terrific line of replay systems. Up to 8 channels of replay and 4K support. So yes, replay in 4K now from Ross. We're gonna have a lot of fun with that. And of course, there's the Mira and Tria video production servers. I can see how that's going to go into a whole lot of really cool systems. By the way, Abekas, before we even bought them, had already implemented a dashboard interface. So they're already part of the Ross experience in the way that you use them. And of course, it gives us a solid line of servers and core technology. But we actually now have our first synergistic product that we're introducing at the show as well, called Streamline Play. Streamline Play adds MOS workflow to Mira servers for news production. So not just sports, but now news. So let's take a look at what we can do with that. Come to the stand, take a look. That's pretty cool. We actually have a product integrating them the day we announce. Pretty cool. Now, Talking about news, Overdrive, of course, is one of our flagship products as well. It is the best-selling production automation system on the planet. There's nothing actually in the world that even comes close to the number of installations Overdrive has. And we're continuing to make Overdrive even better. We wanted to highlight a little bit about that. So we're launching some new versions. One is Overdrive Express. Overdrive has actually been a high-level product, and a lot of people said, can I have something at a lower price? Can I have something that's more accessible to me? I just need it for basic cut-ins, breaking news, some playout assistance, things like that. Now we have something called Overdrive Express that solves that problem. The next one, Overdrive Prime. It's a mid-level system with all the basic tools required to do a full production at an affordable price point. Those mid-level TV stations and productions, that's perfect for Overdrive Prime. And then, of course, we have Overdrive Premium. This one is just loaded with features, and it's the choice of our top network customers. So, of course, with the three versions, Express, Prime, and Premium, you have a system that fits everybody's needs and budget. And of course, because you're from Ross, you can grow from one to the next with no real price penalty. So we're pretty excited about where we're going with Overdrive and our ability to control productions with a keyboard and a mouse. We have some new features as well. Two of them we want to highlight. One is Smart Quick Recalls. This is, you got to come to the booth really to get it. But what it does is it auto-builds quick recalls, touch buttons on the screen, based on the rundown content that's loaded real-time from the newsroom system. So all of a sudden, you have the ability to control not just standard camera one, camera two stuff, but stuff that's in your show as it's happening, and you can go complete random access. So before, you used to have memories on a switcher. Now you have random access of your whole show as it comes straight out of the newsroom system. This is a very hot feature. Also, we're supporting multiple rundowns now. So you can open shows in separate tabs and jump between rundowns instantly. It makes back-to-back shows or coming out of breaks really, really easy. And I want to highlight something here because the National Broadcaster of Canada, SRC/CBC, collaborated with us really closely. They really were excited about working with Ross at an engineering level to get this perfect. And so we did that. And actually, a shout out because I believe they're here tonight. So thank you very much for all of your help on that. It will make a difference in the industry. Now, moving on, another thing, virtualization. Overdrive now supports virtualization on VMware and Hyper-V. So that's another virtualization. That's another word. You got IP, you got 12 gig, you got new products, you got smart production, virtualization. These are all big buzzwords of the show. How about that? Ross is involved with that. We've also tested Inception and Streamline. They're virtualizable as well. So quite a sizable number of our software products work in virtualization already. Overdrive has just been going crazy with new features as well. I can't even go through all the things we're doing. In fact, we've had about more than a dozen new features just in the past 6 months. It's not all that normal, actually, for a company that has such a huge market lead to be going so hard on a product like that. Usually you sit on it and milk it and enjoy it and the shareholders get excited. We're going for it. We're really going for it with Overdrive, so we're really excited. And it's not just Overdrive that's like that. It's all of our product lines. So we have a lot of exciting things that we're showing at IBC. But there's one more thing that I want to talk about. Let's go back and think. It's kind of funny, right? Usually the one more thing, we already talked about buying two companies. How could we possibly have a one more thing after that? And all the things we're doing with the future group. We've been busy. And that's just since NAB. So at NAB, we showed the Acid camera, which is a pretty cool product, launched Ross into cameras. Great features and specs, excelled at virtual with 444 I/O, ultra chrome chromic ears. By the way, that shipping, customers are going on air with that right now. We also launched at NAB Carbonite Black Solo at $5,000 as a starting price. That's launched us into a whole new world. One of the things I will say, manufacturing just told us that our three pick-and-place lines are running now 24 hours a day. Things like Carbonite Solo has just shot up the amount of manufacturing that we're doing. So it's triple shifting, and as a CEO, that's a good thing. But had an amazing feature set, and we include Expression Live CG with this product as well. In fact, we have just announced at NEB that all Carbonite switchers ship with a free software package of Expression Live CG. But what can go with that? Because the acid camera is high-end, it's expensive. We need something smaller to go with Carbonite Black and Expression Live. Well, at IBC, we're going to solve this problem as well. Let's have a look. So, just in case you didn't think Ross was serious about cameras when we got into acid camera, 6 months later, we're launching a very cool small robotic camera. How cool? Well, first thing, it's a great Carbonite Black Solo companion. It's perfect for small studios, city councils, committee rooms, education, but I know this is going to end up in news studios. I know it's going to end up in entertainment. This is going to end up all over the place. Let's take a look at some specs. Full 1080p HD. 20:1 Olympus optical zoom. High sensitivity sensor and low noise. And when I mean low noise, I'm talking about low optical noise in the sensor, but also low noise in the mechanism. It's silent. Very exciting about that. Also, it's dashboard enabled. So all the cool things that you may have noticed that we can do with dashboard, creating solutions and workflows, Pivot is now part of that, and Carbonite can control it directly as well. Here's the cool thing. Guess what it sells for? $2,750. Do you think we're going to sell a few of these? So this is really excited because this is great for systems, and it's also great for distribution channels to solve customer problems. So let's go back to where we started. The Carbonite Black Solo Bundle. Three Pivot Cams, the new Carbonite Black Solo, and an Expression Live CG for $16,245. Talk about a fantastic entry point to get into robotic camera graphical production. I think this is a very, very exciting price point. Jeez, that number is less than some switchers out there that I've seen recently, in fact. Pretty good economy. Anyway, so we can't talk about all the stuff we're doing. We don't have time. What do we have now? We've got graphics and the whole line of graphics and maps, and we have creative services. Remember, we sell art. We sell a lot of art with our creative services. We have the open truck platform. We have production services, Ross Mobile. Remember, we're a production company, not just an investor in a production company in Norway, but also in Ross Mobile in the United States. We've done 700 plus games this year in 40 states. So Ross is now one of the largest college sports production companies in America, which is really cool because what it means here is that Ross truly understands live production. This isn't just an experiment. Asset management, cameras, now with PIVOTcam, chroma keying, now with 444, infrastructure, whole wide line, including Alteryx, control systems with Overdrive, really, really busy, news and social media, IP technology, making chips and helping the industry move to IP, video servers and replay, with now with Abekas and servers in there as well, virtual and augmented reality, now with Frontier from the Future Group. We've got robotics with CamBot, Furio, and I guess you can count PIVOT as robotics as well now, as a hybrid product. And of course, where it all started, production switchers. And I know with Carbonite Black Solo and the whole Carbonite Black line and what we're doing in Acuity, we're not ignoring that. You know, that's the core of Ross, and we're doing really well there as well. So, yeah, there's something to see at IBC this year, pretty sure. Also, there's something more to do at our keynote address as well, because I really would like you to stay, have a chat with all your friends, talk to us, get excited with us about all the things that are going on at our reception. And we also have what I hear is the hottest DJ in the Netherlands to entertain us along the way. So thank you very much for coming. I'm done.